So what did everyone think of that game?
I gotta say, I think the game is great. It's a fantastic game. I'll just do like a quick review. The only negatives I really have to say about it is there isn't a lot of choice. It gives you the illusion of choice, but the choices that you have, the dialogue options, they mostly just converge upon a single choice. And this happens often. Now, I get why they couldn't do a lot, because every time you have a choice, then you have to... That's more work for the developers, and from what I understand about this game, this had kind of a tumultuous development. When it was released, it was really buggy, too. In that sense, you know, I understand. But still, I would have liked there to be more choice, kind of like in KOTOR or Dragon Age, where the choices you make influence the story. Whereas in this game, I feel like, you know, I wasn't really influencing the story, I was just a participant, you know, watching the story. Other than that, the bugs, but, you know, that's kind of par for the course with these kinds of games, so I understand. And when the game was first released, it had a ton of bugs. But they fixed a lot of those. This game reminds me a lot of Deus Ex 1, the first one, and System Shock 2, but honestly, I think this game's better than them. It has better graphics, better combat. I should talk about the combat, actually. The gunplay, for considering what kind of game it is and the time it came out, is surprisingly good. Gunplay in these kinds of games is always notoriously clunky. If you ever played Deus Ex, it's clunky. So, keeping that in mind, it did a pretty good job with it. It was fun. It also has melee combat, which Deus Ex did not have. And that's also really good. And, you know, it gives you a lot of options in terms of how you want to play the game, which is pretty cool. And I could definitely see myself playing this game one day again and, you know, trying a different build or trying different stats and stuff. At first, it's a little overwhelming, but then you get the hang of it. The graphics are great, especially for a 2004 game. It's really, really good. I love the cities. There's so much to do and explore. It really feels so deep, you know? Like, if you compare it to Deus Ex, I know I compared it to Deus Ex a lot, but I think it's a fair comparison. You know, that also had some cities, but I feel like you can do more in this. There's so many side quests, and they're interesting. They're really good. The game is quite lengthy. I mean, how many streams did it take to beat this game? It's a very meaty game with a lot to do in it, and I could have done more, too. The story is also pretty good. It tells it in a pretty good way. The voice acting is top-notch. The characters are interesting. It's a little convoluted, but there's a lot of lore there. I mean, you know, it comes with the territory when you have a deep game with a lot going on. There's going to be a lot of words and names thrown out there. Yeah, it's the kind of game that you really want to play again so you really understand the story and what's going on. Yeah, I mean, the music's great. It really is a hidden gem. Not a lot of people even know about this game. Like, I don't think anyone knew about this game. I don't think you knew about it, X-Infected, right? Nilavani never heard of it before. Zax, I'm sure, never heard of it before. But, you know, this is based on a pen and paper game. And I hope they make a new one. That would be great. I mean, this game came out in 2004, so it's unlikely that there will be another one. But I wish they would. I hope someone, you know, takes up the challenge and makes a new game. Because with today's technology, they can make the game so much better. Yeah. So, I have Plenty of nice things to say about this game, and I would recommend it to anyone. Even if you're not a fan of RPGs, like, it's not like a JRPG with dull combat, you know. No, it's, and the combat is challenging. You know, it's good. Yeah, I was kind of afraid in the beginning that the combat might be too easy. No, as the game goes on, it becomes very challenging. Oh, and before I forget, I should talk a little bit about the stealth mechanics. The stealth mechanics in this game, you know, don't expect like Deus Ex level stealth or Metal Gear Solid level stealth. It's not like that. The stealth in this game is heavily based around your stats. Like I said before, unlike those other games which give you multiple paths to try and sneak by enemies, usually in this game there's only one path where enemies are always patrolling it. So the only way to get past them is to upgrade your stealth abilities, your stealth stats, so that they can't see you even though you're standing right in front of them. Or I should say, kneeling right in front of them. With that said, you know, it works, and it makes sense in an RPG, because an RPG is supposed to be more driven by your stats rather than your player, than a player's skill. So it's not bad, and it does work in this game. To a certain extent. You know, I did a little bit of everything. I did a little bit of melee, a little bit of ranged combat, a little bit of stealth. So I got to experience it for what it was, and you know, you can play it however you want, and I like that. And unlike Watch Dogs, it doesn't like incentivize, you know, just combat. You get experience points for completing missions, quests, and that also incentivizes you to play a lot of subquests. So that's it. That's Vampire the Masquerade.